Hello everyone, this is CoolPro195 with part 10 of Let's Play Skylanders Giants for the PlayStation 3, and here I have a brand new guest commentator. Introduce yourself.
Sup, Strong31, what's up?
Yeah, and I'm here back with the revival of my Skylanders Giants Let's Play. That's right people, I'm bringing this back because I had this Let's Play on my case for quite a long time now. And I really feel that it needs to be done. And, you know, I might as well get it over and done with instead of trying to, you know, trying to balance everything all the time. But yeah, just gotta speak to Flynn right up on the wheel. Okay, I seem to be getting stuck every corner, but... Yeah, let's do this.
So how many Skylander toys do you actually have?
I have plenty, but like most of them were from the very first Skylanders game. Yeah, I was thinking of getting more, but then that... You know, just commitments came along with everything. So yeah, we're doing Chapter 10, Aerial Attack, people. Okay, ghost ship, alright. I see now. They're... Some innovation, now they're bringing ghost versions of the actual enemies. Well, these ghost archers don't seem to be doing much damage, but... yeah. Ah, pizza. Okay, so he said to use a gun. I wonder where... Yeah. Oh, holy shit, I can't actually get past these. Wow. Okay, welcome back to the first Skylanders where we're actually shooting stuff with a cannon. The fuck? We're shooting melons. Oh, that's weird. But yeah, people, this is... In case you've forgotten, this is a blind Let's Play, and... Yeah, I figured I'd do this Let's Play after a long time, since I've really been meaning to do it, and... Just gotta be done. So anyways, what have you got to say about Skylanders Giants?
I've never played it, haven't really been interested in like the Skylanders game because you have to commit yourself to buying like a lot of toys.
Yeah, pretty much. It's Activision's new route of making money. Yeah, we know Activision. Very well. Also sucks that you can't monetize Skylanders videos as well.
You can't.
Yeah, because Activision are going to file some bullshit claims. Well, that's what they're likely to do anyway. Anyways, people, just in case you didn't know, this is actually the first part of the Let's Play, which I'm actually recording I actually got a trophy. Awesome. Mind menace. But yeah, anyways, people, this is actually the first part of the Let's Play where I'm actually using the Elgato Game Capture HD to record. And not just that, but also, I'm also not using component cables to record anymore either. I'm using the HDCP pass-through, method. In order to record PS3 game through HDMI, which is awesome. But at the same time, I had to disable like Dolby Digital Audio because the Elgato doesn't support it.
Damn, so we're not gonna be able to listen to your video in Dolby Digital?
Well, I think Dolby Digital, like, they're referring to the game audio itself. But yeah. It won't be like proper native Dolby Digital.
I want to hear CoolPro 195's videos in surround sound, though.
Yeah, that would be awesome. But it sucks that the Elgato has to put these restrictions on.
You need the HD60, that's why.
Yeah. And T-Rex has just died. That scraps the No Lives Lost. Right.
Please remove. So how do you revive Skylanders then, once you remove them?
That's the thing, like, it sucks. You can't really revive Skylanders.
So if you only have one Skylanders toys, you're fucked?
Yeah, if you have one, you're fucked. That's basically it.
What? That's fucking stupid.
Yeah, some concept that is. They should have added something like lives in the game. I never understood why they never did that.
So, how many toys do you have left? It would be funny if you run out of toys.
Yeah. Yo, this is weird. He's not actually slamming his hammer down. He's just using laser eyes. Okay, this is quite fucked up. Okay, Crusher seems to be dying. Well, he's one weak fuck. You know, I might as well remove Crusher because he's really low on health. Okay, legendary bouncer, here we go. Deal with the wheel. I haven't heard that in a long time. That's better.
If I ever get Skylanders or Lego Dimensions, I'm gonna do a one toy challenge, try to beat the whole game with one toy.
Yeah.
You should do that.
Yeah, I would do that. It would be interesting. Like, one figure. But this ship actually reminds me of Pac-Man World in a way.
Why is that?
Because of those levels, like... Because it reminds me of the levels in the last world of Pac-Man World, where at some point you actually reach some deadly or ghostly ship or some crap. It's like the more haunted stage of the game, where like you're near to the end of the game where you have to fight Tok-Man. Ah, sucks. Like, it's funny how the health system they used it, they actually made you like you use it by what it works whenever you collect things like pizzas or stuff like that in order to get your health meter back up. But they could have introduced lives as well. I mean,
yeah,
because like Activision probably figured that a lot of people were actually gonna buy a fuck ton of figures with the game, but not everyone wants to spend that much money. Okay. Okay, gotta smash this. Okay, I'll need a water Skylander. I have to go back to my old Series 1 Skylanders. Let's see what use Gilgrunt has. Apologies if the commentary isn't the best, but you know, this, but in a way it's understandable why the commentary's like this, because it's basically kind of in Vegetation, this Let's Play. That's basically what it feels like in a Let's Play you haven't done a long time and you're just trying to revive. And it's blind at the same time. But you know, just gotta finish this off. Cause like, originally when I started this Let's Play, I was getting a lot of views. Because the game, cause back then, the game was brand new and YouTube system was much better.
Yeah.
I mean, I was getting more views, more subscribers, more comments, like, very easy. And it would be nice if it was like the same outcome these days as well, but it sucks. You know. Like, 3 years, like, yeah, it's been 3 years since I started this LP. Like, 3 years I had this game, or this Let's Play on my case. From 2012 right up to this point, 2015. Speaking of which,
I decided to reboot it.
Well, this isn't technically rebooting, I'm technically just reviving it just so I can finish it off. Because, like, it isn't really professional to leave a Let's Play unfinished, and it also isn't very, you know, isn't very consistent either.
Yeah.
Okay, I might as well ignore these pricks, because they're just wasting my time. Okay, time to switch back. I also can't believe it's nearly 2016 already.
Right? Only like, what, two, three weeks left?
Yeah, like 2015 is just coming to an end right now, and it's been a crazy year. Okay, now I've got to shoot down 5 cannon ships. This level is quite repetitive. Like, this ship, like, feels more like an airport with the, with that whole, like, voiceover sound effect or whatever. That doo! Also, those are one of the 5 things that we have to destroy, I get you. Oh no, it's one of those. God, just not looking at the image properly. I like how they also include a heart, like floating around, like it's one of those arcade shoot 'em ups as well. But I never got how they actually put the controls inverted, which is bullshit. This is what I mean when this Let's Play is like in Vegetation, like it's...
We also need more people.
Yeah, we don't have much to say. This is why I don't like commentating on this Let's Play alone nowadays.
Now, the next part, you should wait until more people get on to do the next part.
Yeah, I'd like to, but at the same time I really want to get this out the way.
ship instead. Here, I'm gonna swing us around, and when I do, you can drop right in on these creeps.
Skylanders of the undead element are stronger in this zone.
Okay, undead element. Well, I might as well switch to Cinder. Like, interestingly enough, Cinder's fucking, what do you call it? She was one of the, she was actually one of the main characters that you can play as in The Legend of Spyro, Dawn of a Dragon. It's like kind of a co-op game, really, where you play as Spyro and you can play as Cinder. Nice, got a winged sapphire. Seriously, I'm just forgetting about all these things that the game had because it's been such a long time since I played it. God, if only I had the time back then. But you know, it's just commitments had to play their role in my life, unfortunately. And I know many of you would be saying that I should be playing like the later Skylanders games because they're much better. I mean, I'm not gonna deny that they are better, but the thing is that they're actually but the thing is I never got the chance to buy them yet, which I'm still looking into, but at the same time I also got a cut back on spending as well. Since like Black Friday came along. Well, speaking of which, I can't believe like Christmas is close already. I mean, it's like it's literally just 10 days away.
Yep.
I mean, I don't know.
What do you think you're gonna? What are you gonna get yourself for Christmas?
I honestly don't know what I might actually get for Christmas. I mean, I know since I'm much older, I don't really expect a lot coming my way. But you know, crazy shit goes on. But you know, I'm probably just gonna get money for the most part, but. But we'll see, we'll see. The atmosphere of this game, in a way, actually reminds me of a bit of Legend of Spyro. Not just because of Cinder, because of the whole atmosphere of the level. Fuck. Shit. Like, I never really actually played much of Legend of Spyro, but nor do I know much of the story, but but apparently I heard that Cinder like apparently died or something, but I don't think that's, but I don't know, like for those of you who played it, feel free to comment in the comment section. Although I'm not really sure if anyone's really gonna watch this Let's Play, because it's quite, because Skylanders Giants itself is actually quite an old game now. It's like a Let's Play of a 3-year-old game, and because no one would really imagine a Let's Play of a 2012 game in in late 2015.
Yeah, what are we on, Skylanders Swap Force or something?
Yeah, this is Skylanders Giants. Now, I'm not actually sure if I'm actually just gonna include like bonus like when I'm backtracking to levels to in order to complete this 100%, I'm not sure if I'm actually going to include commentary in this, since based on how the commentary is going right now. I mean, it's not going too bad, but at the same time, it's not too well either. But I'm just doing the best I can, really, based on what I know. Fuck, I need a bomb really fast, and Cinder is dying real quick. Oh, there it is. Oh, come on.
Die.
Okay, I need to replace Skylander.
Do you have Spyro?
Yeah, I have Spyro. The only thing that sucks is that they make him one of the inferior characters, which... Because, you know, to Activision now, they just make the main character of a wonderful franchise an outcast to its own spin-off. Like, I really feel for what Spyro has suffered. I mean, some people reckon the Spyro was actually already ruined in earlier Spyro games than, like, Skylanders, even though Skylanders isn't technically a Spyro game, nor is it a reboot.
It's a spin-off.
Yeah.
You know what isn't ruined yet and has a chance of coming back?
What exactly?
Crash?
Yeah, possibly.
Before people in the comments start raging at what I said, look at PlayStation Experience from 2 weeks ago. The president of Sony America, of PlayStation America, was wearing a Crash shirt.
Yeah. Okay, now I should use an Air Skylander. Okay, it's time for Jetvac to take his turn. Oh, Golden IDS. It's been a long time since I've seen him. But yeah, the CEO of PlayStation or Sony was actually wearing a Crash Bandicoot shirt on the E3. Not E3, the fucking PlayStation Experience.
Yeah.
And that's what brought a lot of people to the conclusion to think that Crash is actually
E3 2016.
Has a chance to come back. Yeah, in E3 2016. Let's see what the store has in stock for us. Hey.
Like, the whole show was pretty much shitty because I was expecting something involving Crash, but, you know, they never delivered.
Yeah, true. See, our Skystones, I remember them. I might as well buy the Skystone for these mini games that we play within whenever you challenge a character in a level. Like, in every level, well, almost every level, there's this one character or a few characters who challenge you to a game of Skystones. Well, now we're actually back to one of the generic looking Skylanders. Worlds. Alright. I'll probably just include backtracking as bonus content, really. Because I know I also kind of originally intended this to be a 100% Let's Play, but I'd figured I'd... Like, since the way commentary's going, I might as well include that as bonus content. like, probably without commentary. I know it's a let's play, but still, like, if it's not doing that well, then I'm not sure if I see much point. Okay, legendary treasure. I wonder what this is. Skull roof. Nice. And also, I have a question for some of you guys. Oh, you actually sent a message through PSN. What did you send?
The thingy doesn't appear on top when you send it through the app. Nah, I just sent an LP, that's cool.
What did you write in the message?
Skylanders LP? Nice.
But yeah, anyways, for those of you who've actually been watching my this Let's Play that I started back in 2012, and they're actually watching this right now, especially up to this point in the video, where do you think, like, this Let's Play is exactly going? I mean, I know it kind of seems self-explanatory, but still. Like, it doesn't seem, like, very bright. I mean, how was it... basically, what I mean to ask was it, how is the Let's Play to you now in comparison to how it was back in 2012? Because, like, for me personally, the Let's Play back in 2012 was actually... I had a lot more hype doing this Let's Play. Not just because this is, like... Yeah, also, like... Especially since this is a brand new... It was brand new back then, and we were also... And it was actually a big innovation for the franchise. With giants and everything. But at the same time, it sucked that they still couldn't jump, so it's kind of like a second Crash of the Titans of the series. It's like Swap Force is the mind over mutant of the series, which introduced jumping. But anyways, time to return. Hang on, how am I gonna get up there? Oh yeah, bounce. I'm baffled. Which way am I supposed to go now? Alright. Oh, there's one of those Lockatron wheels over there. It's been a long time since I've seen one of them. But yeah. Skylanders is actually a great franchise, like, as its own, really. It doesn't really work as much for a Spyro game, if people want to consider it as a Spyro game. But there's still no reason to bash on Skylanders. I mean, it's a good game, but, like, I don't know, the novelty for this game, for me personally, has kind of worn off. Simply because of how it has progressed and how everyone is just portraying it. It's probably because of the fan base and everything. Like the way they interpret it. Oh, Soul Gem. Fright Rider. Okay, there's a nice little preview there. But anyways, what would you lot actually prefer for me to do, like, when it comes to backtracking stages of the Let's Play? Like, do you want me to actually make them like the proper Let's Play parts with commentary, or just include them as just bonus content parts of the Let's Play, and just keep the commentary like to the parts where I'm actually progressing through the story of the game? Cause, like, it'd be interesting to actually know your opinion on this, because, like, and don't ask why I have the idea of just including the backtracking and all the challenges as bonus content, as just generic bonus content parts, because I pretty much explained it earlier, so yeah. Just telling, by the way, commentary is going, just me and Andrew, like, it's fair enough for Andrew not saying much, because he doesn't really have much of an insight from Skylanders, and I've been trying to find a suitable commentator who can actually commentate in this as well. And he's not doing too bad, but, you know, this part could be better.
Yes, it can.
Much better. I'm just trying not to dwell on it. I know it kind of sounds depressing too, but it's just something we gotta live with. I'm just wasting time with fucking jetvac, like, doing that. Okay, bitches. Oh, really? Legendary bouncer happens to die right now? Fucking piss take. Now I've got to switch to pointless oldum.
Wait, how'd he die?
Crusher. I don't know, he's like really low on health, and as soon as he came on, he died. I don't know if Elgato. Wow! Well, Crusher's a fucking retard. Now he fucking died and all.
Yes, yes, have all your toys killed.
Yeah,
that'd make the part better.
It's the death of thousands of Skylanders figures. But yeah, this Let's Play so far is seriously in Vegetation. I'm gonna bring Eruptor into the game because he's kind of equivalent to a giant, but not exactly. I mean, those are the only three giants I have. I only have Tree Rex, Crusher, and Legendary Bouncer. There. That makes it much easier. Just fucking sucks that I can't use any giants now. Right. It's taking forever to bring up the bomb. To be fair, these Skylanders games weren't actually perfect either, but, you know.
How long is this part gonna be?
I don't even know. I'm only recording a level per part, so. And I don't even know how long the levels are. It's a blind Let's Play, so yeah. I mean, probably if I knew this game much better, I probably would have more to say. But, you know.
Yeah.
Just needs the right time and dedication. God, that bomb just doesn't want to appear. Okay, then let's open up this present over here. Alright. It's funny how these hats actually make the Skylanders more able to give. I don't even know how to describe it, even. Fucking life commentary sometimes sucks. But yeah, just gotta live with it. Oh well, at least I'm back on the ship now.
Oh, when that crazy pilot of ours swung the ship around, I fell out and landed here. You can check it out if you like, but it's way too cloud-like for my taste.
Alright. I wonder if I've been there already, I don't know. BLC. Fucking hell, I'm just trying to remember what I was gonna say. God, it just sucks when that happens. God, I'm definitely not liking this part. Oh no, I've already been here. Or have I? Raptor sounds like a motorbike or some shit. Okay, so apparently these switches are actually doing something. I doubt this is gonna get much views, but I'm just doing this to fill in the blank spaces, really. As this is an old Let's Play I'm trying to revive, I wouldn't be surprised if I don't get much views on it. I don't really care if anyone has any criticism towards it either. At the end of the day, it's just something I want to get out of the way. God, Eruptor. He's really running low on health right now. Oh, shit. Oh, come on. Nah, this is very tense right now. It's one of the scariest moments in Skylanders, when your figure's about to die. I also doubt that I'm gonna finish this level in record time as well. I never understood why they had like record time in this game as well, like you have, in order to finish this level in under like a certain time. Oh, for fuck's sake, I really need to watch out for the missiles falling from the sky. Oh, for fuck's sake, now Raptor's dead. Okay, I think you're gonna like this one, Andrew. I'm gonna play as Spyro. You still there? Hey, let me see. The Skype call seems to be full. Yeah, people have been saying they were busy, so yeah. Oh, Andrew's actually gonna eat lunch. Whoa. Okay. Fair enough. Anyways. It's not as if I was able to tell since my TV's at... is literally at the other side of my laptop. So, yeah. Oh yeah, I've forgotten the last plot. I actually gave Spyro a graduation hat, which he's wearing right now, or whatever it's called. But just for the sake of not knowing what it's called, I'm just going to call it a graduation hat. Yeah, also apologize for all the pauses in my commentary, the whole blank spaces and everything. I mean, I seriously do. I just can't help it. In fact, there's not much to say then. Wow, now this guy's using like some big ass robot. But chompies, it's been a long time since I've seen one of those. Oh, those are some next devil chompies right there. It's like they all literally came from the dead. Well, they're fucking ghosts, no shit. Like, see, this is what I mean. Like, I'm trying to avoid saying stupid things as well. But, you know. But at the same time, I don't really care. Anything to fill in the commentary. Just kind of feels out of breath. At the same time. All right. I wonder what gave him the idea to actually come up with the idea for a robot or something. And like undead enemies. They were probably running idea for new enemies or something, or didn't they work that much on concept art? Well, I understand for like introducing new characters into the game such as the obvious giants. But you know, fuck. Shit, Spyro is now low on health. Crap. It'd be a real shame because Spyro is one of my favorite characters in this game. Well, pretty much Spyro is the main reason why many people actually bought Skylanders to begin with. So, I don't see why I would not love Spyro. It's a fucking awesome character. It's nice how he can fly as well, but it's not the same. It's not really free. It's not free roaming like it was in the original, like in the original Spyro games, where you can just literally fly all around the world and you don't have to walk all over every single platform and shit like that. Wow. Okay. Now that, don't tell me that doesn't remind anyone of Crash Bandicoot, come on. That reminds me of fucking, what you call it, Temple Ruins and Jaws of Darkness. But with those big green doors smashing in. I can actually picture the music playing here as well. Dun 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 da da da. Fuck, that was close. Dun 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 da 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 dun 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 da 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 dun 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 da dun dun. Okay, timing is everything here. Made it. Yeah, just I don't know. I had to sing the tune. It's better than like not doing anything at all. But you know. Okay, end of the ship. Well, at least it's interesting that. Okay. Anyways. Yeah. As I was gonna say, it's interesting how this level actually lets you. I got me. Even though this Let's Play is not doing that much, that well in the commentary for this part, like I gotta say, it's for this level in particular, it's actually quite interesting that they give you the opportunity to explore more sides of Captain Flynn's ship. Yeah, that's how they pronounce it in the game, Captain Flynn's ship. It's like you can see how it's spelled in previous parts. You see that and you know what I'm talking about, but yeah. I like how it gives you more of the opportunity to explore more areas of the ship instead of just that same generic area which you just use to access other levels. I mean, it's kind of acts like the homeworld really, even though this isn't exactly a homeworld. It's not like Homeworlds of Spyro, it's literally just like one base area where you just go to one place just so you can go to the next level, and once you've done the level you can just pause and go back to them easy. Although they call them chapters in this game, I never understood why, but I don't know, they decided to be more chronicle or something, if that even describes it perfectly, but I don't really care really. But feel free to correct me if you like, but just don't be a bitchy asshole though. It's cause like correcting's one thing, but being bitchy while you're doing it, it's just highly unnecessary, it's pointless. Like nobody asked for it, no one asked for any drama, so why try and make a scene out of it. You know, it's just completely uncalled for. Now, the next thing I'm wondering is how I'm gonna get up there. Okay, that's interesting. Like, wherever he throws like his bomb. Oh, I see what. Oh, yeah, I remember what Flynn was saying. It's just, you know, kind of feel like I'm getting old as well. Especially since I've been in YouTube for a very long time, and I've just reached my 20s as well, which was kind of a surprise at first. But yeah. That machine's getting wrecked. Excuse me, I just had to let that negative energy out. It's interesting how whenever their bombs don't actually hit you, it transforms into a bomb that you can use. I'm not gonna lie, that was an interesting concept. Nice, I synced the dreadnought. Okay, that was amazingly dramatic. Okay, now that's this level finally complete with just one star, and I'm. Wow, Sky Survivor. Well, you get a trophy for every level, so yeah, but still. It still feels kind of rewarding at the same time, and I know I didn't collect everything and clear it under, but like I said, I might do this I might either do this as a proper, I might do the backtracking stages as a proper part, or a fucking, what you call it, or as just bonus content for the Let's Play. But yeah, that was a nice little dramatic explosion they included right at the end of the level. Like, it's funny, whenever I see an explosion, it reminds me of Halo. Alright people, so basically that's that's the entire level complete, and unfortunately Andrew couldn't finish his lunch on time before I finished the level. But anyways, that pretty much puts an end to this part. Feel free to subscribe, like and comment to leave your feedback based on the thoughts of whatever's been mentioned in this video, and also your thoughts on the comparisons that I have made, and how this Let's Play is currently going as of now. And also, like, feel free to stay tuned for future projects, such as more upcoming parts of this Let's Play, and also live streams as well. So anyways, that's pretty much wraps up this part. I hope you enjoyed this video, apart from this part being what it was, and see you lot in the next part, or probably a future upcoming project. Laters everyone.